connected to Wi-Fi.
Hello. In today's video, I present to you Aerolix excellent and well-priced DAC, UP 2 Stream HD DAC, AirPlay 2 High-Res Wireless aptX HD Audio Streaming Board. Output 1:1 up to 24-bit, 192 kHz. Protocols: AirPlay 2, DLNA, UPnP, Spotify Connect, Tidal Connect, Qplay. NAS. Support NAS with DLNA support. Full specs in video description. I will make a box for the circuit board, and additionally I will make a board with buttons for autonomous operation of the device. I cut two covers, top and bottom, measuring 260 mm by 240 mm. For this purpose, I use transparent acrylic with a thickness of 4 mm. I also use two boards with a thickness of 15 mm. I sand the cut clear acrylic with 2000 grit and then spray paint with black matte. I drill holes in the covers to attach them to the wood part. These are the boards I use. I cut the required dimensions from the boards using a laser for greater accuracy. I sand the cut boards with a vibration sander to remove the black scum from the laser. The finest sandpaper for sanding is 250, finer is not necessary. I smear the boards with stain to achieve a more saturated and good color. I varnish the boards with an oil-based varnish, because when it dries there is no gloss. I cut four aluminum angles and drill holes in them. I fasten the angles to the wooden part with rapids. I place the bottom cover and fasten it to the wooden part with snaps. I drill holes for attaching the board. I drill holes and put rubber feet. I cut two pieces of 2.5 millimeters thick mirror acrylic. The laser I use can't cut clear acrylic. I use it to etch the front and back panel elements for more accuracy. I hand drill and sand the holes on both panels. I fasten the board with 3mm bolts. I place the back panel and fasten it with bolts and screws. I solder and place the power connector. I stick the audio connector labels. I line up and solder the micro buttons to a piece of circuit board. You can see the button diagram on the left side of the screen, or you can download it from the manufacturer's website. I solder the buttons. I make a common plus on the buttons using the soldering iron and a little more tin. These are resistors of the correct value and must be soldered and connected to the buttons. You can see the diagram with the resistors and their values on the left of the screen. I connect the resistors and buttons using a ribbon cable. I attach the buttons and display to the front panel using super glue. I cover the wires with warm silicone so I don't break them while assembling the case. I assemble the front panel and place it in place in the box. I stick the circuit board with the resistors using double-sided tape. I connect the cables to the board and the display. I put the power switch. I connect the cables and power for the board. For power, I use a phone charger with exact parameters, 5 volts and not less than 2A. I glue the antennas for Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. I also stick ice tape for illumination of the box. I use the same 5 volts power supply. I put the top cover on and fasten it with snaps. On the buttons you have functions: next track, previous track, volume up, volume down, pause and mute. In the mode, there is a change of the outputs of the board and a reset of the system. Thanks for your interest.